Hey guys, I want to talk a little bit about something that happened to me today. So I just got home from chasing. I decided I was going to chase my backyard. It's been kind of a quiet spring and that sucked. So we had a marginal risk up here in southern Michigan today, a couple low-level tornado parameters. But, you know, I figured, what the heck, I'll go shake some rust off and whatnot. But I want to talk about something that happened to me today regarding the core of a severe thunderstorm. Now, the core kind of gets left out. It doesn't see much love among the chaser and spotter communities. You know, we're focused on things like tornadoes and hail and all the cool stuff, and no one ever really talks about the core. Well, today I had to deal with a core, and I remember very vividly going back, like, to my very first sky-worn spotter class I ever took. It was like in 2003 or 2004. It was a few years before I started chasing, and it was taught by a guy named Carl Ojala, and he was a professor at Eastern Michigan University, and this guy was awesome. Everybody loved him. And I remember him vividly saying during the section where they described the different parts of a supercell, he got to the core and said, this is the core. This is where all the rain and the hail and all the nasty stuff comes down. And you don't want to be there. You don't want to mess with it. You don't want to be in it. And just stay away from it. And he said, and this is forever burned into my brain whenever I think of the core now. He said, you'll hear storm chasers talk about punching the core. Dumb. And he's not wrong. It's not somewhere that you should be. In fact, if you punch the core, you tend to pop out the other side in very close proximity to a tornado, if there is one. Now, I can be dumb from time to time, and it was one of those lessons where I thought, yeah, you know, I'll learn this for myself. And I did. And you know, to my discredit, I've punched a few cores in my years. Dr. Ojala, if you're watching this. But anyway, I've punched my fair share of cores, the most recent, I think, being in 2019. It's not something that I try to do, but it's happened. But today, while I was chasing, I found myself in a core by accident. And I want to share with you what that's like and why it is a bad idea to find yourself in the core of a storm. Is maybe like a PSA or my penance to Professor Ojala for having punched cores during my chasing career. So check it out. I'm going to share some video here from my forward-facing dash cam because my good cameras were off. I was already in some rain and there was nothing really to shoot. So this is from my dash cam, and I want to show you what it's like being in the core.
Okay, here's the quick backstory and setup. I was up here in Clio watching this storm, which was the tail end of a persistent cluster that had moved up from the Indiana border area. And there had been some transient supercell structures popping up here and there to the south, but they'd been fizzling out or getting absorbed into these clusters as they moved northeast. Besides, the better tornado potential was up here to the north, so that's where I decided to go as I followed this thing. But once it became clear that this was also going to fizzle apart, the storm down here was starting to look good, and both my buddies Steve and Michael from TC Vortex were on it, so I gave them a call to see how it looked. And they said it looked okay, but if I could get in front of it, I'd be in a really good position for some photography and maybe a time lapse. So I figured from where I was, I could easily get in front of it by coming down I-75 here, even with storm motion northeast at 60, which is pretty fast. So I left the storm here in Clio and headed down the interstate, and I was targeting an intercept somewhere just inside the Oakland County line. I ran into some of the precipitation ahead of the storm because it too was fizzling out and the rain was spreading out in front of it here. I cleared that and continued down the freeway, but this dark gray area off to the right, you see that? That's the main precipitation core, and it's moving directly towards me, and it's doing it pretty fast. So either way, I thought that I would like just be able to squeeze by, but it was definitely closer than I thought it was going to be. And at this point, I pretty much gave up on getting in front of it because it was moving way faster than I thought. And my really only objective at this point was just not to end up in the core now. But that was essentially wishful thinking. Watch how fast visibility drops as soon as I get overtaken here. Now, I have the audio turned off, but if you really want a soundtrack for this, just crinkle a plastic shopping bag into a megaphone pointed at yourself. Anyway, I think my dash cam sees with slightly higher contrast than the naked eye as well. So to a regular person, myself included, being in the core actually looks more like this. Also, notice how much traffic has slowed down. For a short bit, I wasn't going any faster than maybe 20 miles an hour because traffic in front of me was driving at a crawl. I am very lucky that I wasn't rear-ended. I'm also sure that having a bright red truck helps, as does driving with my headlights on. Which, by the way, if you're ever in rain like this, turn your headlights on! Can you imagine, like, if there was a silver car slowed down or stopped in the road up ahead without lights on? It'd be a recipe for disaster. Anyway, I eventually emerge out the other side, and this storm is no longer a supercell, if it ever was one to begin with, so I don't need to worry about popping out right next to a tornado, but I do want to put a little bit of distance between me and that storm, so once I do, I swing around at an exit to take a look at what I just drove through, and there it is. That's the core that I just came out of.
So yeah, that's what it's like to be driving in the core. Thanks for watching and stay safe.